my thing with cannabis is that I had to use it to survive. I was banished back to the East Coast when I was younger for just hanging out with the wrong people who got me into trouble. And coming to an area where there was nothing, a lot of people were growing cannabis. They were able to buy cars or pay a little bit extra on their bills. Cannabis seemed to be what was like Christmas at harvest. Kia ora, my name is Porourangi Tawhiwhirangi and I'm a co-founder of E3C, East Coast Cannabis Company. E3C is located in an area called Makarika, which is 10 minutes south of Ruatoria.
Are there many opportunities available for people your age around here?
Unless you're just hearty, it's called hearty farmer. Yeah, it's about it. In forestry, it's about the only two for the young fellas.
Back in 2018, you know, we sort of said, what is there for young people here? What do you guys get up to? And the response was, Uncle, we start by selling tinnies to survive, then we start selling bags of meth, and then we become a meth dealer. That's not acceptable. And the first thing they said to me is like, no disrespect, but everyone wants to help us and they're all shit. We want to try and give them that hand up. It's not a handout, it's that hand up to help themselves, and we want to guide them through what we call tuakana taina, which is a big brother, little brother, or big sister, little sister. It's us older ones trying to mentor them, but listen as well. We see a lot of illegal cultivation, cannabis cultivation skills being practiced through different students. We can fit probably about 3,000 plants in this whole plot. Last year, this particular garden was a tutor of the EIT hemp course. The plot next door was from a group of youth that came from Kaikohe that came to visit, and they came to help plant some native plants that we have on our bank, as well as some veggies, and then we got them to plant some hemp for their plot. First of all, it's about getting the young people involved with the whenua. Regardless if it's hemp or natives or vegetables, it's interacting with the ground.
Pretty means pretty much everything, because I got a, this is about a newborn. Yeah, so fuck. This is basically corrected, really. Straight up, full-time job. Yeah, nice Mickey.
He got booted out of school when he was 13 for cannabis, and basically he had to go out and work from there. And even though he has literacy problems, he's showing huge initiative to becoming a leader. So part of what I'm doing with my crew is teaching them how to be the team leader, how to run crews, stuff like that. So even though he's hindered by his qualifications, it's not going to hinder his where he can step up to.
Got a bit more responsibility, like growing up a little bit more. Yeah, learned way more than what I was doing before, anyways. Yeah. And it's just, yeah, it's helped us with my family and whatnot. Yeah, it's kai on the table. Yeah, OG.
We've been hammered by cannabis prohibition for years. I just had a feeling to get up and stand up for the people in New Zealand who have been doing it illegally. This industry, I feel, belongs to them. These people have had to hide away, and you know, they've been labelled as criminals, but a lot of these people doing it are just your average Joe, your mother and father, or your auntie and uncle, your nanny and papa. They're not gangs.
Have you seen it cause any harm in your community?
Cannabis? Not harm, but like, not harm. Might have called rari-rari, yeah, between the cops and that, but that's just the only way our people got to go, eh? It's the only way,
What needs to change for that not to be the only way?
Give our people a chance in like growing dope like legal, so we don't have to fucking go in the bush and hide away and shit like that.
I guess for cannabis will get us to go to the next levels and grow as a cannabis company. We will then start pursuing the recreational industry if the government and New Zealand allow us to. If it's no, we will still encourage these rangatahi, teach them and guide them into that medicinal industry. And there's people around us that want to support, like MSD and that, but the support's not coming fast enough for these younger ones, so they're not going to wait around. You know, for them, when we're trying to help them, they love it, but they always got to go home to what's going on in their environments, in their lives. So it's a huge cycle at the moment that's going, not that it's going nowhere, but if we had more help for these younger ones, then, or more support for them, then it'll give them more of an opportunity to weigh up their options. And at the moment, they haven't got very many.